Why esmolol is given by IV infusion? What is esmolol? Esmolol is a beta blocker, and beta blockers can be classified as non-selective beta blockers as well as selective beta blockers. So these selective beta blockers are selective for the beta 1 receptors. So non-selective beta blockers include propranolol, timolol, nadolol, and pindolol. So many drugs are there which are non-selective beta blockers. Again, we have a list of beta 1 selective blockers. Among them, esmolol is one of the drug. Now, esmolol is a selective beta 1 blocker. What are the selective beta blockers? Already we have seen one is the esmolol, and other drugs include atenolol, metoprolol, acebutolol, nebivolol, and bisoprolol. So even we have a list of selective beta blockers. Among them, esmolol is the only one drug which is given by IV infusion. For example, we can give the selective beta blockers by oral route, and few of these selective beta blockers like the atenolol and metoprolol can also be given by IV route, but as a IV bolus administration, that is a single administration by IV route. On the other hand, esmolol is only the one drug which is given by IV infusion, that is a continuous administration of the drug by the IV route. So now in this video, let us see why this esmolol is given by IV infusion. Why it is given as an IV infusion? So drugs can be given by IV route as IV bolus or as IV infusion. When we give the drugs by IV bolus administration, suppose a drug is having a high first pass metabolism so that it is not suitable for the oral route, then it can be given by IV bolus administration. Otherwise, if we require the drug action immediately, particularly in the emergency conditions, then we can give the drug by IV bolus administration. Now, the selective beta 1 blockers are not having significant first pass metabolism, so they can be given by the oral route. And whenever they require an emergency treatment, they can be given by IV bolus administration. But in case of esmolol, it is given by IV infusion. So when we give the drugs by IV infusion, when a drug is short acting, then the drug is given by IV infusion. For example, esmolol is having a half-life of around 9 minutes. Half of the drug is going to be cleared with every 9 minutes, so it is very short acting. So we have to administer the drug continuously by the IV infusion in order to retain the pharmacological actions. Before going to see why this esmolol is short acting, let us see first of all the structure of the esmolol. So this is the structure of the esmolol, and now we can observe an aryl ring here, that is the phenyl group, and this phenyl group is attached to an oxy group which is then attached to the propanol amine. So that's why these beta blockers are commonly called as aryl oxy propanol amines. And to these aryl oxy propanol amines, whatever the group at the para portion is very important, and the group at the para portion will dictate the pharmacokinetic parameters of the beta blockers. Now this esmolol is having the three carbon chain, and we can give the numbering here 1, 2, and 3. So it is having a methyl propionate, that is an ester group, at the para portion. This ester group is responsible for the short duration of action of esmolol. Now let us see the metabolism of this esmolol. All we have seen is the structure of this esmolol, and esmolol is having the ester functional group, and this ester functional group can be cleaved by the esterases within the erythrocytes so that it can be converted into free carboxylic acid. Now this free carboxylic acid metabolite of the esmolol is having no significant activity on the beta receptors. And because of this metabolism, esmolol is very short acting, so it is having a half-life of around 9 minutes. Where it is given? Esmolol is having an onset of action around 2 to 10 minutes, and the onset of action of esmolol can be improved by adding a loading dose along with the IV infusion. And duration of action of esmolol is very short, and it is having a duration around 10 to 20 minutes. And because of this short duration of action, esmolol is given by IV infusion. So esmolol can be used in the conditions like in the treatment of atrial fibrillation and flutter, in the emergency treatment of tachycardia, esmolol can be used. Esmolol can block the beta 1 receptors selectively, thereby inhibits the both rate as well as force of contraction of the heart. In this way, esmolol is one of a drug of choice in the clinical settings for the emergency treatment of tachycardia as well as atrial fibrillation and flutter.